We welcome you as you listen to this recital of music for Advent, carefully chosen and played by Mr. David Lee on the Willis Organ of St. Patrick's Cathedral, Dublin, where David is organist and assistant master of the music. The programme, which features music by three German composers, Nikolaus Bruns, very little of whose organ repertoire has survived, Johann Sebastian Bach, and Max Reger, both of whom have left huge musical legacies, reflects the spiritual journey from darkness and despair to light and hope through the Incarnation, the birth of God's Son, Jesus Christ. Nikolaus Bruns is one of the tragic figures of the organ world. Born in 1665, close to the town of Husum in northern Germany, near the border with Denmark, he showed huge musical ability as a child and later studied the organ with Dietrich Buxtehude, who regarded him as his finest pupil. A virtuosic violinist, he was known for playing two or three solo lines simultaneously on the violin while playing the bass line on the organ pedals. Nikolaus Bruns died aged only 31, and regrettably, only a very small number of authenticated organ works has survived, among them the work with which Mr. David Lee opens this recital, Bruns' Chorale Fantasia Nun Komm, Der Heiden Heiland, literally, Now Come, Saviour of the Nations, a hymn which, by tradition, was sung in Lutheran worship on Advent Sunday. This comprises four sections, each developing a line of the chorale melody. Within a narrative idiom, Bruns' use of rhetorical pauses after the initial statement of the theme might be taken to depict the sense of longing and unfulfilled anticipation characterizing the season of Advent. The chorale fantasia Nun Komm, Der Heiden Heiland by Nikolaus Bruns. Now we turn to the music of Johann Sebastian Bach and three chorale preludes on Nun Komm, Der Heiden Heiland, literally, Now Come, Saviour of the Nations, BWV 659, 660 and 661. Apart from the opening prelude in the Orgelbuchlein and no fewer than five cantata movements, the only extant settings of this chorale by J.S. Bach are the three in the 18 or Leipzig chorales, which contains chorale preludes first composed no later than Bach's time as court organist in Weimar between the years 1708 and 1717. It seems likely that the Nun Komm preludes were intended to form a triptych. BWV 659 is in some ways conventional with its melismatic solo melody, but the walking bass stands out as something different. Its addition to the texture imparts a somber yet searching character to the music. The bass of the second prelude is again a defining feature, but while in BWV 659, the bass stands somewhat aloof from the chorale-derived remaining voices, in BWV 660, the bass parts are in the foreground, vying with each other in close imitation. The chorale melody appears in pithy, rather stylized phrases in the right hand, but it is the virtuosic interplay of the left hand and feet that constantly demands attention. BWV 661 is a fugue in organo pleno, for full organ. The driving angular subject is derived from the chorale melody, but introduces three startling leaps, two of an octave and one of a minor sixth connection with the chorale. The pedal provides the real thing in minims below the turbulent three-voice fugue. The three chorale preludes on Nun Komm, Der Heiden Heiland by Johann Sebastian Bach. Dachat Of Ruft Uns Die Stimme, BWV 645, is one of the best-known chorale preludes by J.S. Bach. It is among the six Schubler chorales which Bach had engraved and printed by Johann Schubler around 1748. Five of the six are known to have been transcribed from a movement in a cantata, while one was probably transcribed from a cantata that was later lost. All are for an organ with two manuals and pedals, making the collection an approachable and marketable version of Bach's music at a time when few of his cantatas had been published. BWV 645, which David is about to play, is well known and much loved. It is transcribed from a tenor chorale in the fourth movement of the cantata by the same name, BWV 140. The chorale prelude on Wachet auf, Ruft uns die Stimme, BWV 645, literally Awake the Voices Calling Us, or perhaps better known as Zion Hears the Watchmen's Voices, by J.S. Bach.
Thank you.
music of Max Reger has a special place in organ repertoire, and he is regarded by many as the greatest German composer for the pipe organ since J.S. Bach. Born into a musical family in Bavaria in 1873, Reger was also a pianist, composer, conductor, and academic teacher, and led to his appointment in 1907 as professor of composition in the Leipzig Conservatory. He died in Leipzig in May 1916 on his way back from a concert tour of the Netherlands, aged only 43. Reger's chorale fantasia, Wachet auf, has always held a secure place in the organ repertoire, with its well-known Advent tune, clear structure, vivid, almost impressionistic evocation of its text, and its engaging fugue subject. It opens in the darkness of midnight, perhaps portraying a world not only slumbering, but spiritually lost, whose torpor is disturbed only by periodic bursts of violence. The arc shape of the opening chords faintly foreshadows the chorale to come. The transition from the murky depths of C minor to a radiant E major, as the chorale appears beneath a starlit haze of harmony, is among the most magical in all organ music. The darkness is not easily dispelled or the world aroused, but gradually the texture clears and gains momentum for the second verse. Here the tune is first accompanied by triplet quavers in a joyful lyricism. This leads to the moment of greatest excitement, the coming from heaven of the bridegroom, for which the tune passes to the feet beneath cascades of triplets in thirds, like the pealing of Christmas bells. The excitement subsides for the last part of the verse, in which the crown of heaven and the evening meal, not only the joyous banquet in heaven, but also the precious Eucharist on earth, are contemplated in music of beautiful introspection. The concluding fugue is unusually transparent in texture. It rarely exceeds three parts for the first 50 bars. As the imitation becomes more complex, however, a sublime C-sharp minor passage in five parts heralds the arrival of the chorale tune in counterpoint with the fugue subject, firstly in the pedals, then in the left hand, and finally in a full chordal texture. The chorale fantasia on Wachet auf, ruft uns die Stimme by Max Reger. the chorale fantasia Wachet auf, ruft uns die Stimme by Max Reger brings to an end this recital by David Lee on the organ of St. Patrick's Cathedral, Dublin. We offer our deepest gratitude to David for his superb playing and for organizing this and many other recitals. Very well done indeed. Thank you. And thank you for listening.